Good morning everyone, Thorin Heiser here, and welcome to another ArchiCAD mini tutorial. Today we're going to look at creating a billboard to place in our ArchiCAD model so we can see this image in front of us. You see here, I've loaded up a JPEG of a simple silhouette of a tree that you'll be able to download from my education website. Now what we need to do is, the first step is to delete this white background, make it transparent or an alpha channel, so we can just see the black silhouette of the tree. Now to do that, just open the file in Photoshop, and I'm just going to go over here to the layers and double click on this background layer because it's locked, and just go OK. That will unlock it and make it layer 0. Then I'll go here to the erase tool, and I'll click on Magic Erase Tool, and I can just click on the white background. Now notice how it's deleted everything that's white. Now if you have contiguous turned on, it'll only delete these white bits one at a time. Make sure it's unchecked and it will delete all of the white. So what we're going to do now is we're going to save this image as a PNG file. So you go File, Save As, and we go PNG. The reason we pick a PNG is so we can save the alpha channel or the transparency. The transparency is the checker pattern here. Now I'm going to go to my computer and I'm going to make a new folder and I'm going to call it My ArchiCAD Library. Now I suggest you all create a folder somewhere where you can add all images and anything you create to this folder as your own ArchiCAD library, because we're going to attach that to our ArchiCAD. This is the same thing you do if you create your own library parts. We just put them in this folder. So we go there and we just click Save. For interlaced, click None and click OK. And it saved that image. Now we're going to go into ArchiCAD, which I have open here. Now the first thing we're going to do is, we're going to attach that library. Go to File, Libraries and Objects, Library Manager. Click to Add, and then navigate to where you had that library. To our ArchiCAD. There it is. Just go Choose. Go OK. So we can use that image. There we've got it. Nothing special has happened. We need to create a new material that has that JPEG as the bitmap for that material. So we go to Options, Element Attributes, Materials. Now I'm just going to duplicate that brick face one and go underscore tree. The reason I put the underscore there is it'll be the first of my materials. Change that surface color just to black. Vectorial hatching, I'll make it empty or airspace because I don't want any vectorial hatching for the tree. And here in the texture, I go Select, and you'll see if I move right up the top, I can minimize the ArchiCAD 14 library, and there's my ArchiCAD library there. And I go Silhouette, and go OK. And now I need to make sure the alpha channel effects of transparency are turned on. You can see here, it's now transparent. And this is the aspect ratio, 720 by 685 of the image. So if I go Keep Original Proportions, it'll adjust it to be the size of the original file, to make sure you do that. So if I make a wall 720 millimeters wide times 1812 high, it'll be the size of one tree. If I go get that sample, I make it down to 1:1. There you go. So I'll just remember that. I'll actually go to my sticky note. Hopefully you can see that. Maybe you can't. I'm writing it on a sticky note here so I can remember what it is. Just the thing of Windows. So now I've set up my internal. I need to go to my Lightworks, and I just do the magic match with internal render, internal engine. Go OK. So now I'm going to go to my wall tool. I'm going to make a wall that has 100% solid fill as the cut fill, and make it 0 thick. I'm going to make the height of that wall 1812 because that was how high it was in the image. I'm going to set the material to be underscore tree for all sides. And go OK. Now I'll draw this wall and I'll make it 720. And now if I jump to 3D by pressing F5, you'll see I have my wall. I just changed to perspective mode. I have my piece of wall there with the tree. Now the problem is it's not centered, or sorry, it's not starting correctly from this point down here. You can fix that quite easily. Click on the wall, do it in 3D, go to your design, align 3D texture, set origin, and you click there. So now I have my tree. Now one last step, I'm going to duplicate this wall. I'm going to move it so it's the center on the center. And then I will group them. And I will make several copies. Now I'm going to do a slab. Jump back to 3D. And if I do a Lightworks render, I'll zoom in a bit closer. You'll see here I have my trees and the shadow is showing the actual tree. Now it still is just a flat tree and there's still a bit of white around the edges. That's because of the image. You can fix it up in Photoshop if you want, but I think that looks fine just for a quick billboard of a tree. Now you can do it with a real picture. For the students taking my digital communications class, I asked you all to take photos of yourself doing something. Now I would just cut yourself out, cut the background out. So you want to take a photo on a simple material, or use the, if we go back to Photoshop, I'll undo here. Use this tool here, the magnetic lasso tool, and if you click, it'll snap to things that have a color change. That can take a while. You'll probably get it reasonably rough first time round, and then you have to zoom in real close and tidy it up. But yes, that's really the best way to do it, to create some fast trees that look. You can do it with real trees as well, not just silhouettes, so they'll look a bit more realistic. Well, I hope you've enjoyed it. Thank you very much.